sail order comes, then it means you confirm the sale, sale order is coming, and then what happened? That sale order, on the basis of sale order, production starts, right? When production initiates, it means you create a job, right? When you create a job, it means on job, there are three things: direct material, direct labor, and manufacturing overhead, right? So on material, there is going to be material requisition form, and that include direct material. So direct material directly go to job cost sheet, which include these three we just saw in our earlier slide, and also material in the form of indirect material also go also recorded in requisite form in case of like wooden carrot, the needles, lubricants and all the stuff, also is coming from the material department over there. So, but this will go to the manufacturing overhead account. And then there is employee. So employee time tickets is, it's directly coming to the job cost sheet. So the indirect laborers, like those who are supervisors, the security guards, janitors, salaries, these kind of time tickets, they will be going to the manufacturing overhead. So, but in advance, right, we call this, so when production is happening and we are recording the data, so that is our actual data, right? So material is going to the, actual material is going to the manufacturing overhead, actual time ticketing, indirect labor, actual other charges. So this data is coming after the production stop, but before that, when we accepted that order, we used POHR, right? So we used POHR and we entered the job cost sheet and we said that, okay, this will be beneficial for us or not. So then we accept the order and production starts. And now the actual data coming, and actual data is replacing the place of estimation. So when actual data is replacing the estimated, then there is a difference, right? So in that case, let's talk about the flow charts here. So when raw material is purchased, right? So I'm not going into the journal entries and all the stuff. Let's talk about the T accounts. So recall your discussion. T accounts are created in accounting. The right-hand side is called credit. The left-hand side is called debit, right? The rules that we discussed are that assets increase, debit, asset decrease, credit, right? Recall your discussion. So when raw material is purchased, raw material increased, raw material is our asset, asset increased, debit. So it is debited with the amount here. Cash decrease or accounts payable increase, that is the other side of the entry. So, but the thing is that in a factory, inventory takes three forms. Number one is the raw material. Number two is the work in progress, so semi-finished goods. And number three is finished goods, right? So in a factory, raw material is also your inventory. So you are converting raw material, unfinished goods, they are also called your assets and under inventory. And also there is a finished goods that is yet to be sold. This is also your inventory. So how the system flows, raw material transfer to work in progress, right? When work in progress is complete, then it is shifted to the finished goods. So let's talk about the flow chart and the accounting procedures here. So raw material goes to the work in progress. So work in progress includes both direct material, direct labor as well, right? And indirect material goes to manufacturing overhead on the actual side, right? So applied side would be written like here, because applied would be treated as some kind of like in advance estimation. Estimation is kind of like a contra account, which is treated as reserve. So recall your discussion of the contra account. If in actual sense the account is debited, its contra account is credited. So the credit side is called applied, right hand side is called actual or debit side. So when raw material purchase, entry would be and raw material purchase on account, raw material to accounts payable. So if you have any difficulty to understand this, please stop me here and I would be repeating that stuff. David, you are following the point. Chandra, Sipade?
Yeah. Yes, sir, I'll let you know.
Yeah.
Okay, good. So when the direct material goes to the working progress or an indirect material goes to the manufacturing overhead, so entry would be, so here, the direct material issued to a job increases the work in progress. It increases the work in progress and decreases the raw material. Why? Because raw material is transferred to work in progress. Similarly, the indirect material that is also coming from the material department that is also used, but that would be charged to manufacturing overhead. So decrease in raw material is going to be decrease in assets. So that's why it is debited. And increase in working progress is also our assets. Working progress is our asset, and manufacturing overhead is our expense. Expense increase debit. Working progress is our asset. Asset increase debit. And decrease in asset, raw material decrease, decrease in asset, decrease in inventory, which is asset decrease, credit. So this logic basically 100% applies here. So entry would be your raw material is transferred to working progress and the manufacturing overhead. So previously we have working progress that is coming from, on the basis. Now the flow of direct labor. So in working progress, we already transferred the material, and now through time ticketing, the salary is payable, right? Salary, the labor receives salary after 15 days or maybe after a month. So how much time they have spent, that is payable. Accrued expenses, recall that, concept. Accrued expenses, expense occurred but not paid. So they worked. So that's why it is payable. And now this is transferred to the cost of work in progress. Work in progress is your inventory, right? And also indirect labor is also going to your manufacturing overhead. What would be the entry here? So the cost of labor incurred increases the work in progress, right? The cost of indirect labor also increases manufacturing overhead cost, right? And since we didn't pay that, if the question says that, okay, they will be paid in cash on the day, on daily basis, then here it would be a cash, not the salaries and wages payable. So since they would be paid in future, so we create accrued liability, accrued expense. Accrued expense is our liability. So working progress, manufacturing overhead to salaries and wages payable. And now the other overhead, like, the electricity charges, this kind of stuff. So all the actual overhead, it must be charged to the actual manufacturing overhead. So remember, actual manufacturing overhead is the debit side of the manufacturing overhead, right? So we should charge all the expenses to the actual oversight. So remember, all these other expenses we still didn't pay yet. We will be paying after, because most of the, you know, salaries, taxes, utility bills, they come on monthly basis. Maybe this job is for just for 2 days or 3 days or 4 days, right? So that's why we create payables, right? So don't just get confused, okay? Because expense increase mean debit. So there is no expense increase debit. Rather, we are creating liability. So this liability is basically accrued liability, accrued expense, right? Expense occurred but not paid. It means we will pay in future. So that is our liability. On the other hand, we are increasing our manufacturing overhead, which is actual, right? The debit side. So manufacturing overhead to all accrued liabilities, accounts payable, tax payable, insurance, depreciation, and all those, and all those stuff, right? So now, can you make the entries of all these till H? So that is a group activity. I am establishing a breakout room. All you need to do can you hear me now? David, Christine, Sipadesha. Yes. Chandra?
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay, so I'm making one breakout room. All you need to do, this is a group activity. Everyone is involved, so I'm making just one breakout room. So all you need to do, you need to make the entries. So first, you need to make a journal entry. And then you make, then you need to post it. That's it. Remember that the beginning working progress has the beginning balance of 42,000. Okay. Let me establish a breakout room activity for you. Okay. Please take a picture. We are about to start. And I will be resuming the recording after the breakout room activity. Okay, guys, so we would be doing, since we don't have much time to go through this one, so we would be doing this example in our class activity in our next lecture, and I would be answering all of your questions. Meanwhile, I would be uploading this lecture to our both BB and WeChat portal. Please download from there. Okay, any more questions?
Thank you.
No question. Okay, then I'm going to stop our recording here. So see you next week. Until then, take care. Stay safe.
Thank you.
Bye-bye.
Bye.
Thank you very much, sir. Have a good weekend.